to keep the game working for you. Oh, hello, happy people. Welcome to How to Be a Better RPG Player on Saving Throws Show. I'm Amy Vorpahl, and today we're looking at all the glorious things you can do for your tabletop gaming experience after the game has ended. Five big old tips today, so let's get after it. Postmortem. First up, postmortem your game for yourself. Spend some time going over what went right, what went wrong, and why. Come up with ways to adjust and talk to your game master about new ideas. Create! Be a creator. Get creative. Create! Role-playing games are inspired by storytelling. Let the game inspire you too. I have to take a moment and let you know that I wasn't a songwriter until I started playing weekly D&D at Saving Throw, and now I have an album called Songs in the Key of D&D, and it's the only thing I get inspired enough to write songs about. But it doesn't have to be original songs, folks. It can be parodies of songs. You know, it doesn't have to even be songs that are very involved at all. Create anything. Here are some things that you can create. Write poems. Write up a dream your character had in between sessions. Write a letter or diary entry from your character. A memory from your character's past. A description of a new person, place, or thing that wasn't included yet in your initial backstory. Some scripture from your character's religious practices. An editorial from an in-game newspaper or pamphlet. Draw, sculpt, paint. Make your own fan art. Make a comic strip inspired by the game. Design and paint a mini. Make a fake Twitter and social media account for your character. And feel free to ask the GM if there's anything you can create or write that could actually be used in game, like an NPC or a city description. Create a drink or a dish inspired by the game. Do anything! None of these have to be perfect or even good. The only thing that will happen is you'll get more entrenched in the game. Dive in! Spend some time reading a little bit more. Bulk up on mechanics that stumped you during the game. Learn more about the lore of the world you're playing in, and then try to incorporate some of it into the game. If you do this though, go ahead and alert your GM so y'all can both be on the same page. Goals. Think of each session like a TV episode and come up with a fun, simple storyline or scene your character can try to achieve next session. For instance, a specific conversation with another PC or a small task, something that won't take up too much time but that you can have fun with. As always, mention it to your GM and be open to abandoning it if the story goes a different way. Any and all of the above will simply help you feel more involved in the group storytelling at the core of a role-playing game. And now it's time for a player shout-out! I'd like to highlight a player who gets really involved in the game at the table and away from it too. Check out Sam DeLev on the shows Tempting Fate and Shadows on the Horizon. You can find them on social media at Tchaikovsky. Thanks again for watching. I would love to know what you think. What else can you do in between sessions to make the game keep working for you? Tell us in the comments below, and as always, feel free to ask questions. Remember to like, subscribe, and click on the image of the bell for notifications when we drop new videos. That's it for How to Be a Better RPG Player. I hope you had fun. I know I did. The end. Au revoir. Goodbye.